Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Canadian Tire Center and the Chris Phillips Jersey Retirement Ceremony. After 1,179 games of loyalty and commitment to one team, tonight we honor Senators legend Chris Phillips as his number 4 is elevated to the rafters. It will forever hang alongside the number 8 of Frank Finnegan, member of the original Ottawa Senators and key figure in the Bring Back the Senators campaign in the early 90s, as well as a number 11 of Daniel Alfredson, longtime captain and team leader in goals and points. Mesdames et messieurs, ce soir nous célébrons Chris Phillips, une légende chez les Sénateurs. Son numéro 4 sera retiré et jamais un autre joueur des Sénateurs d'Ottawa ne le portera. To lead tonight's ceremony, please welcome our hosts, Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir Nicolas Saint-Pierre and Dean Brown.
Good evening, bonsoir. Chris Phillips was born on March 9, 1978 to Carol and Garth Phillips of Fort McMurray, Alberta. Chris grew up playing both baseball and hockey, cheering for the Philadelphia Flyers, idolizing Rick Tocchet. When Chris was a young man, his parents faced some health challenges. He was just 10 years old when a virus left his mother partially paralyzed. 2 years later, diabetes caused his father to become legally blind. Chris and his sister Jennifer had to grow up very quickly, and they rose to the challenge helping out. Chris delayed his start in the Western Hockey League in order to be a greater help at home with his family.
Chris Phillips est né le 9 mars 1978, alors que ses parents, Carol et Garth Phillips, ont élu domicile à Fort McMurray en Alberta. Lorsque Chris était jeune, ses parents ont éprouvé de nombreux problèmes de santé, ce qui l'a amené à assumer un rôle plus important à la maison. Chris a représenté le Canada au championnat du monde junior en 1996 et 1997, remportant la médaille d'or à chaque fois. Le 22 juin 1996 à Saint-Louis, les Sénateurs d'Ottawa ont sélectionné Chris Phillips au tout premier rang du repêchage.
Chris joined the Prince Albert Raiders in 1995 and was traded to the Lethbridge Hurricanes midway through the following season. He played for Team Canada in 1997 and 1996, the World Junior Championships, winning gold in both. As his draft year approached, many scouts applauded his character, physical play, and his poise, as well as the maturity he displayed. And on June 22, 1996, in St. Louis, Missouri, the Ottawa Senators surprised absolutely no one, selecting Chris Phillips first.
October of 1997 was a busy one for Chris. On the 1st, he played his first NHL game in Montreal, got his first assist on the 15th versus the Rangers, and scored his first goal on the 30th versus Florida. Over the years, Chris became one of the most respected defensemen in the NHL and was often given the task of shutting down the top lines of the opposition. He was named the alternate captain of your Ottawa Senators in 2006. Throughout the course of his career, he also played 3 times in the Men's World Hockey Championships.
For the Sens, Chris was as stable and as loyal as they come. He manned the blue line for some of the greatest moments in Senators history, including the first playoff series win, the President's Trophy win, some epic battles of Ontario, and the Stanley Cup Finals. Being a shutdown defenseman, Chris didn't score as many goals as some, but when he did, boy did he celebrate. He scored 71 regular season goals and 6 in the playoffs, the biggest of which came in the Eastern Conference Finals, Game 6, an overtime winner in New Jersey to bring the series back to Ottawa for Game 7. The Senators would go on to lose the series, but after trailing 3-1 and a powerful pregame speech by assistant coach Roger Nielsen, who was battling cancer at the time, there are few wins as meaningful to those of us here in Ottawa as the one that evening in May.
Chris a entamé sa carrière chez les Sénateurs en octobre 1997 et il a été nommé adjoint au capitaine de votre équipe en 2006. Il était à la ligne bleue lors de plusieurs des plus beaux moments de l'histoire des Sénateurs. Le 9 février 2012, il a disputé son 1000e match en marquant 2 buts. En 2015, il est devenu le meneur de tous les temps chez les Sénateurs au chapitre des matchs disputés dans l'uniforme de l'équipe en prenant part à son 1179e match.
On February 9th, 2012, Chris played in his 1,000th game, a memorable night when Chris scored 2 goals, lifting the Senators to a 4-3 win over the Nashville Predators. At the time, he was only the 46th player in NHL history to play 1,000 games with the same team. In 2015, Chris became the Senators' all-time leader in games played for the franchise when he suited up for his 1,179th game of his career on February 5th. A nagging back injury would make that record-breaking game the last of his NHL career. During his time in Ottawa, Chris met Manitic beauty Aaron Hancock, and the two of them wed in 2002. The reception was held right here in this building, and I have it on pretty good authority from the janitorial staff that it lasted till about 6 a.m. the next day. Aaron and Chris later added Ben, Zoe, Naomi, sometimes she liked to be called Gnomes, sometimes Sparky, and the family grew and stayed here in Ottawa. But that wasn't enough. In 2014, they also had Curtis Lazar. Curtis tonight, thankfully, is here playing for the Buffalo Sabres. There he is. And Curtis moved in. Curtis moved into the basement. And while his father was still playing and was a star in the National Hockey League, the kids like to tell their friends that they had a real NHLer living in their basement.
Chris Phillips is synonymous with teamwork, loyalty, and leadership. The Phillips family carried those same attributes to their work off the ice. Together, Aaron and Chris have been involved with many charitable endeavors, too many to count here in the nation's capital.
Just some of those causes include, of course, the Candlelighters, Queensway Carleton Hospital Foundation, Project STEP, and Movember, for which many of you have seen over the years some of the magnificent 70s mustaches Chris grew for those events. They have also assisted with the Snowsuit Fund, Project North, bringing hockey equipment to Nunavut, the 24-Hour Tremblay Foundation, and of course many, many Senators Foundation events and initiatives.
Ensemble, Aaron et Chris se sont impliqués dans d'innombrables œuvres caritatives ici dans la capitale nationale, incluant plusieurs initiatives et activités de la Fondation des Sénateurs.
Chris and Aaron, along with other partners, opened the very popular Big Rig Kitchen and Brewery. The Phillips sold their interest after 10 years, and these days you can find Chris busy in the Senator's front office as your Director of Community and Business Development. Chris and Aaron have planted strong roots in our city. They are an example to all of us of integrity and generosity. Their one-for-all attitude has and continues to make our community a better place every day.
Afin de souligner cet accomplissement, nous invitons sa famille à se joindre à nous sur la glace. Please welcome to the ice Chris's wife, Erin, their children, Ben, Zoe, and Naomi, his mom, Carol, and his sister, Jennifer. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Phillips' family.
Over the course of his 1,179-game career, Chris Phillips was a part of many of the greatest moments in Senators history. I'd like to turn your attention to the Bell HD screen for a retrospective of Chris Phillips' on-ice career.
to tell us some stories you may not have heard before about Chris Phillips. We now call upon one of his very best friends, teammates even before they were Senators, having played in the World Juniors together and roommates here in Ottawa in their early seasons. Please welcome your former number six, Wade Redden.
Here we go. Well, always a pleasure to be back in this arena. A lot of great memories we had over the years. And also great to see the Phillips crew again. A tremendous honor for me to be here tonight to celebrate one of the greatest sends of all time. The legacy, franchise leader in games played. He's an old buddy and teammate. He's the big rig, Chris Phillips. Why don't we start with that, the big rig? I mean, it's pretty obvious if you have one look at his stature. He's a large human being, and he's just a big man on the ice, almost in front of the net in the corner, almost impossible to get the puck or out-battle him. But I think what really stuck that, made that name stick, was at one of our preseason retreats. At the start of the year, we'd always get away and good time to welcome the new guys and get together as a team to get ready for the season. And in a remote location, you get a bunch of guys away together. We'd have a night out to do a few things, have a few drinks, but what ended up happening was some wrestling matches. And it was poor Patty Lalim that ended up on the short end of the stick that night. He was thrown around through a door and into the cabin by Philly, so ever since he's been the big rig. And he's done a fine job in marketing that name around town too, by the way. Chris and I, our playing days go way back to junior hockey. We played World Junior in 96 together. And both being from Western Canada, we had an instant connection when we both got here a few years later. I still remember that first year living together. I was in my second year as a veteran, the Wiley vet of 2 years. He was just a rookie, so when we got time to choose in rooms, I got first dibs. So I got the master suite, and Philly was stuck in a pink room all year long. But lots of great memories with all the guys. We had such a tight-knit group. Remember the rides to the rink and the dinners, the movies. We took guitar lessons together, the road trips and memories that's going to last a lifetime. We were like brothers. One thing about spending so much time off the ice, Chris and I both being less shot D men, and over all those years, we're 10 years together, probably count on both hands the number of shifts we actually took together. So I don't know if the coach thought we had a blinder on one side, he didn't trust us to play the right side or something, I don't know. But all jokes aside, I want to, ask to share a few words about Chris. All the memories that just came flooding back. I think what really summarizes the man he is was a comment made by his father, Garth, at his draft. And Garth was asked how proud he was that his son just got drafted first overall. And he said, "When you have a son and daughter like we have, hockey's just the icing on the cake." And that statement speaks so loud to me about Chris. About his roots, about his character. He was and always will be a great hockey player, but above all, he's a family man. And I can still remember we were chatting last night, Carol, you and Garth, my mom and dad. You guys had so many great times over the years. I remember you guys would always get to the rink as early as we did and get to Marshy's for a beer and a few little visit, and there's so many special times. And now that I see Aaron, you guys with your beautiful family, I mean, it makes me so happy to see, that same love and commitment we had from our parents. So you guys are paying that forward to them. It's just so special. So it's truly amazing. Drafted first overall, played all 1,179 games here in Ottawa. And I speak for all the former teammates. Such a pleasure to play with this guy. What a great character. his calm and steady presence on and off the ice. He was such a key factor in our team having success, pushed everyone around it to be better, helped create a culture in this town. He was one that took so much pride in being that shutdown guy, and that role was so key in all of our success. I mean, but I think what really steps out is the way he's raised his game at key moments. When you think back to his 1,000th game, and everyone was watching him, he scores two big goals that night. The way he played in 2007, him and Volchi, the way he shut down and helped us progress all the way to the Cup Finals was just such a big part of that year. And then who can forget that goal in overtime, game six? Brings back so many memories. I guess I also want to celebrate Aaron. Been there almost all the way along here. And you guys are so ingrained in this community and do so much good in this community that some of the charities that Dean mentioned earlier, and you guys had such a positive impact, and you've been such a help with Chris and a support all those years. So thank you, and it's awesome. Now, I see all the new senators and everyone that's going to be coming through these doors and going to see the number four up in the rafters. It's just so cool to know the legacy you leave behind. One of the greatest senators of all time. It's so awesome. Great legacy you're going to leave. Congrats, man. We love you.
Pour présenter une peinture originale de Tony Harris pour ma... Pour présenter une peinture originale de Tony Harris pour marquer cette occasion, to present an original Tony Harris penny to mark this occasion on behalf of the Ottawa Senators, please welcome alternate captain, s'il vous plaît, accueillons Jean-Gabriel Pageau.
We now turn the mic over to our guest of honor. Ladies and gentlemen, your forever number four, Chris Phillips.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. First off, I just want to thank Reds for those amazing words. It's such a unbelievable friendship, you know, before we even got here, but living together, and as he said, the way our families really all became, you know, one big happy family, and you know, I'm extremely honored that he was able to make it out and be out here and share this this moment with me. It's just at a loss for words right now. Thank you. I was going to thank the Sabres for being out here, but I guess I'll thank Curtis. Oh, that's awesome, buddy. You mean a lot to our family, and thanks for being out here, man. It says a lot about what this kid is all about. Just a terrific kid. We're so so happy to have him stay with us and help him grow into, you know, the man that he's become, and awesome to see you out there. I appreciate all you guys being out here. I really enjoy watching this group of players. They have a never give up attitude, and that's what being an Ottawa Senator is all about. I'm so excited to see what these guys are going to accomplish. I'd also like to thank the honoring committee for choosing to hang number 4 to the rafters. I came to Ottawa as a 19-year-old kid in 1996. I am so thankful to the scouting staff, especially Marshall Johnson, as well as Pierre Gauthier, for believing in me that much. I certainly did not think I would play 1,179 games. Still feels like just a dream or a kid from Fort McMurray. My start here in Ottawa did not go the way I had envisioned. I was in and out of the lineup, to even playing forward. It was very humbling and at times frustrating, but I was truly willing to do whatever I was asked to try and help the team win. How to deal with situations like that were made so much easier with an amazing group of veteran players to learn from, like Sean Hill, Jason York, Lance Pitlick, Denny Vial, Sean Van Allen, my first partner, Igor Kravchuk, Ron Tugnut, Randy Cunningworth, my first road roommate, Sean McEachran, Daniel Alfredson, and of course, my housemate, Wade Redden. I'm so honored that some of these guys could make it here tonight. They really taught me how to be a pro. As time moved on, I luckily found my way as a shutdown defenseman, as I wasn't a very good goal scorer. With a couple of great partners in Zdeno Chara and Anton Volchenkov. I cherish the role of going up against some of the best the game has seen, and it was a challenge that I welcome and will never forget. There are a few highlights that really stand out among thousands of memories while playing here. Obviously, my first NHL game in Montreal, my first goal down in Florida, our first playoff series right here in 98, scoring overtime goal in the 2003 conference finals, and of course, going to the Stanley Cup finals in 2007. What a run that was. But what really stands out among all those great memories is the friendships I made with my teammates, the laughs we shared over countless practical jokes, plane rides, hotel stays, and team dinners. I wish I could just stand here and tell stories about all the incredible teammates whom I had the honor of playing with over the years, but we have a game to play here, and I'd just be here too long. They really were my home away from home. Thank you to each and every guy for making it so fun to go to the rink every day. When I look back, truly wanting to suit up and play every single game no matter what, playing through some of the injuries that I endured, just to make a contribution to the team is something I'm very proud of. I was not typically the guy scoring big goals, but believe me, I would have loved to give Ottawa a few more one-arm salutes. But it was feeling great about blocking a shot, stopping a two-on-one, or helping kill a penalty that gave me a great sense of pride. I've always considered myself to be a team first guy, and I'm just so really, really happy to be honored in this way, and I'm humbled beyond words for this incredible honor of having number 4 retired alongside Alfredson and Finnegan. Now, my career with the Senators would not have been possible without the help of so many people, a number of whom I'll acknowledge, but I am sorry that I'm sure I'll miss a few. Right from the start of it all, playing hockey and minor hockey, playing hockey in Fort McMurray with lifelong friends, and all of my coaches in McMurray, but specifically Donnie Olson and Kenny Farrell, who volunteered so much of their time to teach us how to play and teach us a love of the game. I was 15 when I realized that hockey might be the path. I was playing junior hockey for my hometown Oil Barons, for two great coaches in Fran Gao and Gates Genereux, who taught me so much I think they might be sitting up there. Pushed me so much to become a stronger player, as well as so many incredible teammates like Mueller, Aiken, Stewart, Gemmel, and Fatty, who took me under their wing. I went on to play two great WHL hockey towns in Prince Albert and Lethbridge. Now having to leave home to pursue my dream, it was not only the great teammates, but also my billets that had a huge impact on my development. Bill and Vernell Martodam, as well as Rick and Star Davies, thank you so much for what you did for me. Despite these great experiences, it turned out that I never really knew a great hockey town until I came to Ottawa. I was welcomed with open arms right from the moment I arrived. And now, over 20 years later, Ottawa's home because of the friendships I have made. The love and support you have given me and my family over the years has just been incredible. The Senators organization has so many people I need to thank. Without all of their hard work and commitment, none of this would have been possible. Rod Brydon, Eugene Melnick, all of the general managers and coaches who kept on believing in me, especially Brian Murray, who I miss. He had such a huge influence on my career. Roy Malocker, Cyril Leader, Allison Vaughn, Chad Shella, Jordan Slimzer, and Aaron Robinson, who has also helped make this night so special for me and my family. Team doctors, Chow, Kissick, Aubrey, Cregan, Papp, Henry, as well as the medical staff, Wagner, Joel, Townen, Markwick, Nicoletta, and Plater. Without you guys, I literally would not be standing here and probably sitting in a chair similar to one of my mom's. All the equipment staff, Eddie, Woody, Scotty, Cookie, Foles, Alex, Johnny, Coxie, Moff, strength coaches, Randy, Schwartzy, Rob, our PR guys, Phil, Steve, Morgan, BMO, Simo, all of those people are just so influential in, you know, what allow us to do night in and night out, and I'm just so thankful for all those people. Now my family, who I truly feel can share in this incredible honor with me tonight, including my extended Hancock family, Baron Chalene, Christina and John, Sam, Anna, and Thomas, Nanny Ariel, and the entire family. Thank you for your endless support. My sister, Jen, you never complained, never made me feel guilty about how hockey dominated our family's life. You've been nothing but supportive through this entire journey. And I love you, I'm so proud of you, with your family, your husband, Brian, Bridget, Hudson, and Nash. Love you so much. My mom, Carol, my dad, Garth, who I know is watching from up above. You guys are more than I could have ever asked for as parents. Not only allowed me to follow my dreams, you made it possible with your time, your financial commitment, as well as instilling in me the values that were needed to get where I did, like hard work, determination, perseverance. I am so very grateful, and I love you so much. My kids, Ben, Zoe, and Naomi, who look more grown up today than I've recognized in a long time. Wow. The three of you are amazing kids. You have all been so patient and understanding of my life as a hockey player. I don't think you even understand the importance of that, how it affected me. I am so happy that we got to experience much of my career together. I love what the game of hockey means to all of you, the life lessons that you are all learning from it. I love to watch you all having fun playing the game. But more importantly, the people that you've become makes me so, so very proud. Love you guys. My beautiful wife, Erin. I struggle to find the perfect words to tell you how grateful I am for for everything you have done for me and our family. From the little things like making sure the doorbell or phone didn't ring during pregame naps, to managing a very busy household and making it seem easy. I know that you did not think you were signing up for nearly 20 years of this. And you never complained, at least not to me. You put yourself in second place behind the game. You dealt with late nights, long road trips, last minute schedule changes. And you challenged me to be at my best in a way that no one else could. I'm so very proud of what we've been able to accomplish, the community together, and I am so happy that I was able to share it all with you. I love you so much. And lastly, all of you, you have been amazing. You have supported me on the ice, my business ventures, and the charities we've been involved with. As players, we know that all you asked for was an honest effort, and I tried to give that every time I stepped on the ice. We shared some unforgettable moments together, and I'm proud to say that I'm one of you as we cheer on this group of players wearing the Sens logo. As many of you know, I'm a man of few words, and for 1,179 games, I tried to do my talking on the ice. On a night I'm surrounded by family, friends, and the community of Ottawa, I'm again at a loss for words to tell you how much this means to me. But I will be forever grateful, forever honored, and most importantly, forever a senator. Thank you. Merci.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for us to provide the highest honor to a hockey player. The number 4 will never again be worn by an Ottawa Senator. It will live forever in the rafters. The last, number 4. Please welcome Chris Neal, Jean-Gabriel Pageau, and Craig Anderson to help raise the banner with Chris. We now invite Chris's family and Wade Redden to the banner for a group photo.